Now we are going to talk about convexity. Either you call it axiom or property, but we are going to talk about convexity. What do we mean by convexity? We have already learned. Let me remind you that what did we say? We say a set is convex when we take two elements from that set and we draw a line. Of course, that set has to be in Euclidean plane, or you know, it should satisfy some geometric properties, then only we can draw a line through two of the elements. But whenever we can draw a line between two elements, if the line is completely contained in the set, then the set is called convex set. That's what we have learned. Now we are talking about convexity property that a preference should satisfy. I'm not saying that everyone's preference should satisfy this property. But again, we are going to use some mathematical tools, and it becomes lot easier to deal with someone's preference if it satisfies the convexity axiom. Okay, so what do I mean? I already told you that whenever we take a bundle, let's say we take a bundle, and again for simplicity, I'm drawing it in two-dimensional world or two good world, where I have good one here and good two here. And whenever I take a bundle, let's say X, it divides the conjunction set into three mutually exclusive set. Okay, one is set which says with the set which contains all the bundles which are preferred over and all the bundles over which X is preferred by this individual, and third, X is indifferent. So what I am saying that instead of now taking one bundle, now we take two bundles. Let's say these two bundles are X and Y. These two bundles are X and Y. And what we do? We draw a straight line connecting X to Y. What will be the equation of that straight line? Equation would be Tx plus 1 minus Ty, where such that P is between 0 and 1. Let me say here, this is Y and we have a straight line XY. And what does this T denote? This bundle, this particular bundle that we are talking about, bundle can be anywhere. Okay? This bundle can be anywhere on this line. So this distance of the total distance from X, and we will have, depending on value, we will have this bundle here, Tx plus 1 minus T. I will also talk about graphically what it means, but let's look at it mathematically also. We say that in an individual's preference satisfies convexity property or convexity axiom if this bundle is, if this bundle is at least as preferred as X, and this bundle is also at least as preferred as Y. It has a simpler statement. Let's look at the simpler statement. What we will do? We will take X and Y such that X and Y are indifferent, the person is indifferent between X and Y. Means this individual, if he doesn't have any monetary consideration, then he is equally well off, he gets equal level of satisfaction whether he chooses X or he chooses Y. So he is indifferent between X and Y. So in this case, this bundle should be at least as preferred as X. Then we say, of course, this is true for all X and Y in the conjunction set. If you didn't understand the mathematical definition, it is okay. Let's look at it graphically. What we have here is an indifference curve. What does it mean? You take any bundle on this curve and the person gets equal satisfaction. So, we are picking any two bundle x and y, and then we draw a straight line. Let me make it, you know, different indifference curve, so it would be more clear. This is the indifference curve and we are picking here x and y, and let's take a straight line connecting x to y. Okay, what it means is that all the bundles on this green line, what does this green line indicates? A linear combination of x and y. All the bundles on this green line is at least as preferred as x and y. Is it clear? This is one statement of convexity. We can talk about even a stricter definition of convexity. And what is that? What we say that, of course, when we are drawing the line and we talk about any point on this line, then x is also on this line and y is also on this line. So, x cannot be strictly preferred to itself using reflexivity. It has to be at least as preferred as itself. Fine. So, what we do in the strict convexity, we exclude these two points. It means we restrict t between 0 and 1. Again, just for notation, this means any real number between 0 and 1, including 0 and 1, while this one means that any number between 0 and 1, but excluding 0 and 1. This is called open interval. This is open interval and this is closed interval. So, now if we limit ourselves to this open interval, and what we have is that all the points on this straight line excluding x and y are strictly preferred to x and y, then we say that preference satisfies strict convexity. So, here what we have is t x plus 1 minus t y. We do not have to say, we do not have to indicate what happens with respect to y, because the person is indifferent between x and y, and t is between 0 and 1 excluding 0 and 1. This is strict convexity. While the earlier one is, and this is weak convexity. Or in other word, all the points in case of just convexity, all the points on green line are elements of set which represents all the bundles which are at least as good as x or y. Fine? Okay. So, mathematically it is clear to you. Let me ask you that if your indifference curve is like this, is it convex? Let me tell you, you are wrong. How you are wrong? Because I am drawing just one indifference curve. I do not know where in this zone, because you are assuming monotonicity. If you assume monotonicity, then of course, it is not convex, because take any two points and you draw a line. Of course, this is a very poor drawing, but what is happening here? Using monotonicity, you can say this is less preferred than x and y, that is why it is not convex. But go back to an example that I gave you, where what we had, that if x1 plus x2 less than or equal to y 1 plus y 2, then x is as preferred as y. That is what I talked about. So, not exactly the same, we have something like this indifference curve, and your utility is increasing in this direction, then this is convex. Is it clear? In that case, it is convex. Why? Because in this direction, utility is increasing. If I pick any bundle on this line, let us say this line, this bundle is preferred over x and y. So, in that case, in this case, it is convex. So, you have to be very, very clear what you are talking about, which assumptions we are applying, which assumption we are leaving out. Okay? Fine? It's clear? Now, can you tell me what does it mean? Of course, we are talking about it, but what does it mean? Mathematically, it is clear to you, I believe, but can you explain intuitively what does it mean? So, you are talking about, you are at least in the right direction, you are talking about that marginal rate of substitution that we haven't discussed, but we will discuss it. But even before that, what we have here, let's look at it, let's compare this, and of course, here I am assuming monotonicity is satisfied. So, I say convex preferences not convex. Fine. And I am taking a bundle here x and I am taking a bundle y. And if I am taking the average or any weighted average and I am taking a bundle here, what it means that this new bundle, let us call it z, it is at least as preferred as x, or it may be more preferred. So, can I say that an individual preference exhibits convexity if that person prefers balanced bundle over extreme bundles? Kind of it's balancing out. You know, here what's happening in the bundle x, you have lot of good 2 and very little of good 1, while in y, what you have in this example, lot of good 1, but very little of good 2. And how about the weighted average of these 2? Because all the bundles on this straight line connecting x and y, they are weighted average of x and y. What you have is the kind of balance between these 2. So, here one interpretation could be that you prefer a balanced bundle over extreme bundles. When it is true all the time, then your preference exhibits convexity. Is it clear? Now, can you tell me an example when it is true and when it is not true? An example when it is true. First, let's start with when it is not true. Let's say good 1, you have tea, and good 2 is cola. Okay. And I am talking about my consumption at present. Let's say I am indifferent between a cup of tea and a 200 ml of cola. But of course, for most of us, that we would prefer these extreme bundles, extreme bundle according to our definition, according to the way we have discussed, over the mix of cola and 200 ml of cola, the weighted average of cola and 1 cup of tea. So, their convexity would be violated. But how about, let me say, how about if I take average over a month or an year? What it means is that sometime I would prefer if tea, sometime I would prefer Coke. It is not that all the time I would be going for tea only. So, that is how we justify that even in this case, convexity is not violated if we take a longer duration of time. Is it clear? Fine. And you can find such example where mixing two goods would decrease the pleasure. Using this, you can create example where your preference exhibits convexity. Fine, that's one example.